wish I got a torch. I had a really specific torch that had like UV and normal.
Ooh, that'd be cool.
I got it, but I also use it to let my dog into the garden.
Oh, I might, the headlamp yeah. might be a good idea.
It's very warm.
It is extremely warm.
1 cubic meter of granite stone weighs 2.8 tons. So, the height, a little bit over 1 meter. The width, 2.5. 2. And this is not less than 4. So it's always good to work with not less than, more than exaggerated. So if we said 2 by 1, that's 2. By 4, that's 8. So here we have not less than 8 cubic meter of granite stone. If each cubic meter weighs 2.8 tons, then 8 cubic meter will weigh 23 tons. And this is, so this block is not less than 23 tons. This is a lid of a box.
Damn.
According to the dynastic Egyptian information, according to the Egyptology information, the dynastic Egyptians didn't have a compass. And to align the pyramid with the cardinal direction, they used the stars and the sun from the east, northern star Sirius from the north, and so on. But down here, we are in a subterranean structure. You can't see the stars or the sun, yet they managed to align all the boxes.
To magnetic north.
To magnetic north.
Wow. That's inside
here. Inside here is a some recent excavation, not very recent, it's a few years now. But they discovered that the Serapeum extends.
Oh.
And there are more chambers and boxes.
They have the wooden boxes with the... With
wooden? No, the wooden boxes, it goes back to the Middle Kingdom. Okay. They believe this was being achieved from the site period and then further. The site period. The site period that took all the older sites and reused it, they think they established this, and they think the rest is Greek or Roman.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Ministry of Antiquities. You see, they chopped this because they used something to... So they broke a piece. But you can see the amount of quartz in this. Yeah.
Oh. Hot sip. سنو آبت سري آخد خرحم النسو بيتي شباكة عن خجت يعني في العام الثاني في مطلع العام الثاني الشهر الثالث من فصل الفيضان
اللي تحت هو
اللي هو شهر يعتبر آخر 11 زي الأوقات ده
أيوة أيوة
تمام
خرحم ثواني من الأول تجي
حات سب في مطلع العام الثاني سنو
حات سب means this is a date here
yeah yeah yeah
حات سب means in the beginning of the year أيوة تفضل يا باشا
مطلع العام الثاني السنة الثانية
the beginning of the second year of ruling
في الشهر الثالث
from the third month شيمو which is the third month back then is like nowadays
من November من فصل الآخت اللي هو فصل الفيضان
yeah from the time of the flood so we used to have three only winter and summer and the flood
خرحم إني سبيتي تحت حكم جلالة ملك مصر العليا
under the ruling of the owner of the bee and the reed, which means translated into the king of upper and lower Egypt. Shabaka, the Shabaka?
Shabaka, أسرة 25, عصر نوبي, تمام, عصر متأخر.
Okay, from the late period. Shabaka is from the 25th dynasty, the بتاع كوش, from the kingdom of Kush, from Sudan, when they ruled here in Egypt.
عن خجت فليحيا أبدية.
To live eternally.
مري, نرى أول مري, حبو وزير, حبو وزير, إين حور كم, يعني محبوب. العجل أبيس الأزيري إين حور كم ده اسم السور نفسه إين حور كم هو مخصص السور اللذيذ اللي هو كاتب
اسمه The beloved of حابي
حبو تمام مري حبو وزير إين حور كم يعني محبوب العجل أبيس الأزيري إين حور كم
The beloved of the Apis bull The Osirian, Apis bull, or Serapis?
Yeah.
In Hukim is the name of the bull.
Yeah, hmm. The name of this bull.
Hukim means black, by the way.
كانوا بيختاروا بعناية جدا الصور.
Like an actual bull.
The word happy here is where the word apis came from. When the Greeks are pronouncing hep, it's pronounced as ep. And then they will add the S to relate everything to masculine. Same like the other title, Uzir became Ozoris. Hur became Horus. Nebhat became Neptis. Isid became Isis. All this is the influence of the Greek pronunciation
on the ancient. ضاف لأسماء الأعلام تمام أسماء الأعلام اللي هي بتبقى اسم
وزير حبي
اسم المكان أو اسم أشخاص بيضيف لها اس فتبقى زي أزير أزيرس أسد أزيس أسد
لازم أسامي أماكن
أسامي الأعلام الأعلام اللي هي الأسماء الأشخاص والأماكن بيضيف لها اس ضيف العصفورين تمام إين حوركم ده اسم التور نفسه مخصص
الله ينور عليك يا باشا
What if the lid fell on your laptop?
Me too. I would be crushed.
What is this?
ده بأشعة مقطعية ولا
بيعملوا أشعة.
What is this? Mapping it out.
Scanning it.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's
awesome.
Yousef, what is it? Closed in the end.
There is a chamber to the right and a dead end.
So okay. were those glyphs? And you think they're written at the same time as the thing, or is it more of it? Yeah, right. It's a little.
Come on.
Okay.
Work. So you have a tool with a bigger tip that you move bigger chunks. And then you have a smaller tip. And then a smaller tip. Until you reach that. And then you smooth and smooth and smooth and smooth and polish and polish and polish. This is the progress.
Yeah, a long ways to go.
Huh?
Yeah.
The thing I don't understand. How were they gonna complete the work in this narrow space?
Yeah.
Down here.
Were there other pieces made afterwards? Was there already older ones and then other ones also they tried to imitate?
Mm-hmm.
All these things are acceptable.
Imitation.
Huh?
Got a blue light.
Okay. So, can you see how smooth and shiny the inside is? For some reason, they focused more in polishing and smoothing the inside more than the outside, which doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
Because the inside, it doesn't make sense if it's an apis bulbari. Look how shiny. Look, it's reflecting the light. This is the box that August Mariette found and used explosives. To open it because he couldn't move the lid. It's shiny.
So they blew that open with explosives?
Yeah, they blew this and
all. Why would they do that?
It's from it. They claim that he find the apis bull inside and with some jewelry and stuff. There is no inscriptions in the book. So this who made the burial, they never left a name.
Yeah.
They never said like during the king in the second year or whatever, like the other one.
Mm-hmm.
So where is it? Why is there no photos of the stuff?
Where's the gold?
Found?
Yeah.
Where is it?
I'm gonna run a backhoe and uproot that tree. I want to know where the gold is. I want the gold. Give me the gold. I want the gold.
Write online if you find a picture or something of it, please send it to me.
Yeah.
No, it's not harm. It's only.
The leveling horizontally or vertically?
Yeah, both. Automatic.
But maybe the wood is not.
No, yeah, the wood
It doesn't have to be.
Automatic.
Oh.
This will do it.
You see, it's.
That mesh. Nice.
Wow.
But zero?
No, the first two ones, they were zero. This one, you have to see, it's like the. If you should check the edge here.
It's a slight.
Yeah. Mm. But on the first two ones, they were absolutely...
But can you see the inside?
Yep.
What do you think of the inside? More accurate?
I have no idea.
But we should?
Yep.
Turn it off.
Ramsey.
5-0. The polish went even in the scoops.
Yeah.
And this would be impossible. Please have the light on. Huh? And this would be almost impossible for that method of the manual. And this is what led me to think, how did the polish, that shiny surface became in the deeper part. And it led me to find the truth that there was a liquid that they gave a layer of it on the top of the granite. And gave it that shiny surface after it was smooth.
So that's...
And it's a strong action because we don't have anything like it today. And if we do, it's not going to last for 1,000 years.
Yeah.
Or even 100 years.
Okay, so that's a coating. That's a coating.
Exactly. It's not an acid.
I got the impression it was some kind of acid making it.
No. It was... we will see. We can... I thought it was acid. That acid... No, because this... The coating and the...
These look pretty sloppily chiseled on compared to everything else.
Yeah.
It has this distortion.
These shitty little carvings on.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't get it. He was
these carvings are shit.
He was saying to get out.
Oh.
Yeah.
And then we all just jumped.
He kicked me out. But, okay. But I got a bunch of photos
in
there.
You fucking went in.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It was a good time. Dude, it's like a... Dude, they got a... there's a mini bar.
PlayStation.
It was actually a pretty good setup.
Stripper pole?
Yeah, there's a stripper pole.
Things that matter, dude. Yeah, the ancient Egyptians knew a thing or two, dude. Whoa, what? That's what she says.
This part's not as smooth.
No, it's got that chicken scratch on it.
But this is what it's dated with.
Yeah, just like some dude just graffitiing on it, right?
Right. This is like the worst.
There's one snake I saw that was like pretty lazy, but I saw one that resembled a DNA strand, which is pretty interesting. They had like a double helix one.
Really?
Like right over here, I think. Right here. Kind of, I mean, it, you know.
No. That's cool.
What's this guy?
Palm trees.
Nice, that is a palm tree. So, what do you think the distortion is from here?
Yeah.
What do you think? What? How did that happen?
You mean?
It looks distorted, right?
Yeah. No. Okay. The idea was there were cracks.
Okay.
And then they came, but they had to do that long. Surely you would have inscribed it. If the inscriptions were contemporary with the box, they would be disappeared.
Yeah, right there, okay.
It's thousands of years later.
Good point.
Damn, I wonder if someone's going to study my graffiti in like 1,000 years, right?
Like I told you there was
an old piece of wood with billabong on it.
I'll calibrate it.
Look over here. And so this is still, you can't quite see. So this is aligned pretty much at magnetic north perfectly?
It's about 2 to 3 degrees off of magnetic north, which could have changed since the point where they, because it's constantly moving.
Yeah.
So if you did some quick math, I'm not doing the quick math,
but
you might
be
able to figure out the way the magnetic north has been moving for the last 5,000 years.
The precession of the
equinox. It may have been exactly due north.
Plus
they put
or minus,
it in.
Yeah.
Are you at 352 or are you at
353?
So, no stars. Somehow they were able to align this giant 40 plus ton thing to the north in these strict corridors. I don't know how they do this stuff.